here once again with another song from their new album is Switch.
After commercial.
I'm on the communication deck of the Battlestar Galactica with two of the people who work here. Maren Jensen, who as Athena. See, that's a nice name, Athena.
I had nothing to do with choosing
that's it. Nice. she operates the scanner. And Terry Carter as Colonel Ty, the second in command of the Battlestar. Has working on, now this is the biggest hit of the television season. And what has that done to both of you? How has it changed your lives? Suddenly knowing, wow, we got a hit. Have either of you ever had anything like this before in your careers? That kind of security? Well, you know, you're not going to get a pink slip next week.
Right. Well, as you know, I was on McLeod for 7 years, and that was a hit. It was kind of a slow-burning hit. The first 2 years we were on the air, a lot of people didn't even know we were there. We kind of slipped through. And people said, yes, when are you on? I said, well, we're off for the season, but we're coming on again. You know, they were doing that kind of thing. But the regularity of McLeod helped my regularity, I must tell you that.
Funny, Terry, that's a word you can't use on TV unless you're doing a commercial.
Oh.
Regularity. That's all right. I did one yesterday. You want to hear the classic of all times? I have a stunt woman on the show, and without thinking, I said, so they pay you by the trick. And it was a nighttime audience, and the whole audience went, and I didn't know what I had said. I mean, all these years, and I thought, I mean, never mind. I said, I don't know where this audience came from, but now, this is, Maren, this must be a thrill for you.
It is a thrill. It definitely is.
Where have I
is.
Seen you before? Your face is familiar.
He says that to all the girls. So be careful.
No, that's an old line.
Well, I work right down on Hollywood Boulevard and Vine.
Wait. You should see some of her tricks.
Paying by the trick. No, I'm a brand new face on the tube. This is really my debut. It's my first thing.
Have you been out here trying for a long time to get something like this?
She's not telling you everything. You've seen her picture in thousands of magazines
That's exactly what I mean. You're a model. You were a model.
I was a model for about a year. I modeled...
Yes, but you were successful in that year.
I guess so. It's funny. I sort of took the job on as a lark. I was at UCLA studying acting on a scholarship. I started modeling to pay the bills. Before that, I was waiting on tables and doing all sorts of odd jobs. And to support my acting career, I just modeled. It took off. Mm-hmm. I was really surprised. I had a lot of work.
Did you like it? What's that like, modeling?
It's completely different from acting. I can't even think of the two in the same breath.
It's hard work, isn't it?
It's hard work. It's concentration on just a single frame. It's nothing like acting.
You bought a house, didn't you?
I'm trying to buy a house. There's a big difference. But, that's one thing that the show has changed. While you asked that question to Terry, I was thinking, really, not that much has changed. I mean, people aren't screaming on the streets when I walk by and any of that. It's sort of a gradual thing.
Right?
I don't know. I just don't see that many young people in my neighborhood or at the store. But I have been able to think about buying a house, and I am sort of in the process
of doing
that.
How do you like the prices? They're like Social Security numbers, the prices
they
of
are.
Houses.
They are. They're telephone numbers, actually, you
I
know,
not believe
seven
it.
Digits.
That's right.
Really frightening, but...
People back east, when you tell them about the way the prices of houses have gone up there, they look at you like, you know, you're putting them on.
That's right.
But it's ridiculous.
The thing that Maren is saying is that most young people can't afford to buy a house in California anymore.
True.
And the kind of prices you pay for a house here, I always think, God, if I ever go back to New York, I can buy 3 square blocks. You know, for what I pay
Where?
For my
really?
House.
Where, Terry?
No, not the South Bronx.
Definitely not.
But the fact is that houses here cost much more than, you know, I used to think $50,000 was a lot to buy a house.
That's not even the down payment.
No,
no,
you can't even buy a
exactly
garage
right.
for that.
That's
you know.
Right. Yeah.
No, I know a good garage in the middle of Hollywood.
I'll take it. I'll take it.
Terry, there are viewers in the New England area
Hi there.
Who recognize you having been in a different TV role. I know what it is, but tell them, because that happens to be our home station in that area, the one.
Oh.
Yes, I know. For 3.5 years, I was a newscaster. I was an anchor man on. Can I say the name of the station?
Of course, oh, it's my station.
Of course.
WBZ.
WBZ.
Loud and clear in Boston.
I didn't know that.
Oh, sure. Well, I've got a lot of things to tell you,
Terry,
about
just give me, look into the camera. Which is the close-up camera, guys? This one? Just look into there and give it the WBZ. Good evening, folks. And I'll just give me your lead in then. So,
good evening, folks. Here's the latest news.
No.
I haven't done it in such a long time. I said, let me see. Good evening. I can't remember how I did it. I can't read it.
You must have been quite a newscaster.
No, really, it was. It came very easily, but I can't get into it now. I'm wearing a
that
different
outfit
hat
is it. That outfit
that's
is
the problem.
It.
That's the problem. Yeah.
And since you said you were a regular guy, I mean, you can't get back into that old.
I lost my credibility.
They're calling you the new Farrah Fawcett. Does that?
Who's calling me the new Farrah Fawcett?
Everybody's calling.
Lee Majors.
No. Are you ready for that kind of popularity?
I don't really think about it. I don't know if. How many people are calling me the new Farrah Fawcett?
Well, enough so that I heard about it, okay?
Oh, okay. I don't think about it, really. I really think about doing the job. My life is so removed from all those things that are quote-unquote glamorous. It's getting up and coming to work and being here all the time.
Having done it this one morning, it's not really that thrilling, folks, getting up at this hour, you know, and they're putting that stuff on your face and you're going... Trying to just getting the focus is another thing, you know.
That's true.
Sure.
Everybody thinks this work is so glamorous. It's the waiting in between that would drive me up
you.
A wall.
Mm-hmm. That's the part. That
what do you do? What do you do with your time when you've got the waiting period? And they say, okay, cut. Now you walk away, and you have to wait until they call you for the next scene.
Well, there are a variety
so what do you do
of
with that
activities.
Time?
We socialize on the set. Terry's on the phone, I think, getting his other 10 projects going. What do? I usually go into my dressing room and I bring books, magazines. Mm-hmm. I sometimes bring a tape recorder and I'll sing in there to some music. Or
wonderful.
Well, you know, Maren, she made that remark because it's a kind of a running gag on the set. As soon as we break a scene and I'm not needed, they know that I'm going to go to the telephone because I spend most of my time in touch with my office. I have a production company, and I've got a whole lot of projects going, documentary films and educational
films.
And I've got a couple of feature films in development, so I've got to be in touch with that. And of course, when I'm on the set and I'm doing a scene, my total concentration is here, but the minute they say cut, I'm gone, and they know I've got a telephone growing out of my ear, practically.
Right.
These the thing that fascinates me about these computers is that I'm told they all work.
Oh, yes. They're real.
They work even harder than we do, actually.
That's hard to believe.
I'm kidding.
But there is a game that is played with this particular one, correct?
Yes, there is a game. There are more than one game. There is more than one game.
Terry has been quite diplomatic about this. She said, you go ahead, Maren, and play.
Sure.
Because I think he knows Maren is a killer on this game.
Right.
So let her get old Mike, you know.
I'll sit and watch. Thank you.
Oh, okay.
So you're
going to
show me
out.
How this works?
Yes, I will.
Okay, now you have the advantage. This is your home ground.
This is my home ground, and
I'm learning for the first
know
time.
Know the computer language. Here, this is your guy, and you're trying to hit me, and I'm trying to hit you. Now, the way it's played is that you enter an elevation angle, like 0 to 90 degrees, okay? Mm-hmm. That would be an arc like this. Plus the number of bags of powder, which would be your power, which would send it over, and you try and hit like that.
I've got to loop it over.
Right. But what happens, which makes it complicated, is that there's a wind factor of 46 miles per hour this way.
Oh, I'm playing downwind.
Right. You're playing, you have the wind to carry you, and I've got to go against the wind. So, here goes.
Tell me about the smog factor, Maren.
There's a very big smog factor. You are first. There's your guy. Mm-hmm. So... I would suggest an angle of about, let's say 30 degrees. So type in 30.
Like?
Yeah, right here.
Oh, 30.
Plus. Now, I would say about 5 would be a good, or 6, and then push this, the return. Here you go.
Oh, thanks a lot, Maren.
Well, you know, I did my best. All right.
You're really a sweet kid.
Now, here I go. I'm going to push 10 plus, I'll try 8.
If find O'Meara, I had one bag of powder, and I just did away with it.
The powder wasn't dry either.
All right, so what would you say would be the angle? You definitely need a higher angle.
Oh, I would
but
say.
But the higher up you go, so you'll have much more power from the wind. So,
Let's try 50.
Okay, 50, and how much powder do you want? Power.
Power. What did I have before? Because
I
only
had
went about...
six.
I went about,
What would you say?
14.
Well, you're going to go...
Let him push some buttons.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And this,
the
this
return.
One?
Return.
Watch this, guys. Watch this. Holy Toledo. Look out, Burbank!
Right to the moon.
That's terrific, Marin. You really know how to hurt a guy.
Well, Mike, what can I say? You win some and you lose some. I hope you're better at some other things.
Marin,
I think you are.
Marin, Mike says you're going to be back on the show in June.
It'll be a cold day in June before you're back on the show, Marin. Thank you, Marin, and thank you, Terry, very much.
Well, I don't know what to say.
I'm kidding. And we'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Presenting for the first time anywhere, the Tubber Brothers.
I don't want her, you can have her. She's too fat for me. She's too fat for me. She's too fat for me. I don't want her, you can have her. She's too fat for me. She's too fat, she's too fat, she's too fat for me.
I get dizzy, I get numb when I'm dancing with my jump, jump, jump. Oh,
I don't want her, you can have her. She's too fat for me.
What?
She's too fat for me. She's too fat for me. I don't want her, you can have her. She's too fat for me. She's too fat, she's too fat, she's too fat for me.
Can't she prance up a hill?
No, 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 no.
No. And she danced from a thrill.
Oh. No, 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 no.
Does she fit in my coupe?
By herself, she's a group.
I forgot to look at her eyes. I don't want her, you can have her. She's too fat for me. She's too fat for me. She's too fat for me.
the rest of my guests, lovely Jill Ireland, her lovely daughter Zuleika, Jeff Conaway, Leonard Nimoy, John Gavin and me tomorrow, when my guest will be Andy Williams and the Avenger himself, Patrick McNee.
Promotional services for the Mike Douglas Show are provided by Delta Airlines, which flies to over 90 cities nationwide. Delta is ready when you are. Some guests of the Mike Douglas Show receive a True Test calculator from True Value Hardware Stores, who provide value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. Limousine service for the Mike Douglas Show provided by Playboy Limousine. The all-new Ford LTD for 79, a new American road car designed to take you across town or across the country in full-size roominess. Test drive it on your own roads.